Hey guys, I miss having you guys in class every day, but I figured I would put something out for you guys while we're apart so that's something that you guys can work on, something to keep you occupied, and just something fun. So I'm technically not supposed to be giving you guys any new material until after our spring break, but we will kind of get into that, and I'll send your parents kind of notifications on how that's going to work and everything. But for now, let's just kind of do some fun stuff, okay? So what we're going to do is we're going to talk about, learn very briefly about what's called a 12-bar blues. And it's something that you guys can practice at home, and you don't need me there with you because it requires a little bit of improvisation or improv. Now, if you remember when our students from Holly Springs High School came and they did improv, they just talked about how they were taking a concept and they were just making up whatever they wanted to with that concept. And that's kind of what we're going to do, okay? So the first thing to understand is what 12-bar blues is. So it's called 12-bar blues because it consists of 12 bars of music, 12 measures. And each measure, a chord is being played. Now, I have a little whiteboard here, and you're going to be a little confused by it at first. These are what are called Roman numerals. So this one right here is a 1. Okay, it looks like an I is a 1. The I with a V next to it is a 4, and then just the V is a 5. That's all you need to know is 1, 4, and 5. Now, what they mean is they're telling us a specific chord to play based off of what key signature that we're in. So we're going to be using our concert B flat scale, so the one that 6th grade we did our playing test on. It's like number 147, I think, in our book. 7th grade, you guys did it last year, and 8th grade, you did it 2 years ago. It should be a scale that everybody is very, very comfortable with, okay? So what the Roman numerals mean is that a 1 means I'm building a chord off of that first scale degree. So my concert B-flat scale, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, okay? My 1, if I'm building a chord off that, that's my 1, okay? For my 4 chord, I go up to the 4 scale degree, 1, 2, 3, 4, build a chord off of that, that's my 4, okay? That's my 4 chord. And then last one is a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I do a chord off of that 5, that's my 5 chord. Or you can have it down here, okay? So 1, 4, 5, that's the only 3 chords. And you don't need to know about the chords, how to play them. You just need to know generally what's going on underneath. And this applies to every single blues song ever, okay? So you can see that for the first 4 measures, I'm all doing 1 chords, okay? So for the first measure, second measure, 1, third measure. Then I go up to a 4. For 2 measures, come back to 1. And I do a 5. Then down to 4. Then to a 1. Now the last one, you see how it says 1, but it's kind of 5 in parentheses. Some people will do it at 1, some people will do a 5, usually a lower 5, and then it restarts back over, and we start at the very beginning, okay? So there's a lot of songs that use this this 12-bar blues pattern, and I'm gonna show you guys one of them. One of them is a very, very common song that you're probably going to recognize called Hound Dog by Elvis. It follows this very, very simple pattern, and I'll kind of follow along with it for you, okay? You ain't nothing but a hound dog, girl. One. To cry all the time. One. You ain't nothing but a hound dog, girl. Four. Crying all the time. Well, you ain't nothing but a rabbit, and you ain't no friend of mine. One. And then he stops on this one. One. And then he restarts. Well, that was just a lot. Yeah, they said you was high class. Well, that was just a lot. And you keep going over and over and over again. That's the kind of the cycle for a 12-bar blues, okay? Now, what we need to know to be able to play this is we're taking our concert B-flat scale and we're just modifying a little bit to get what's called a blues scale. So if you look in the link that's below this video, there should be a little PDF of music. And if it's not there below, you can always go to my website, hrmsband.com, and I'll have a section up there for all this online stuff. I'll probably have this video posted there too, but it'll have that PDF with the music. So you can print this off if you want to. If you just want to keep it on your computer, that's also cool too. But this is your 12-bar blues scale for a B-flat major scale. Okay. So you can see that I have the numbers written there underneath. That is just in comparison to your concert B flat scale. So sixth grade, you guys are a lot more used to this right now, but we went 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and we did a lot of those different exercises, like the pyramid exercise and everything, knowing it by the numbers. So I just put the kind of the modifications from the concert B flat scale just to give you a better idea. So it's 1, flat 3, 4, sharp 4, 5, flat 7, and an 8. Okay. Now the first line is for flute, oboe, and mallet percussion. The second line is for clarinet, tenor sax, trumpet, and euphonium. The third line is for alto sax. Fourth line is for horn. Fifth line is for trombone, and the sixth line is for tuba. Okay. Now I put the blues scale in 2 octaves. You really only need to worry about just that first octave. The second octave is really kind of for more of my eighth graders. Some of you seventh graders may be able to do at least some of them, but you don't have to worry about the entire second half. That's just some extra options. Okay. So the blues scale as we would hear it. Okay. The way that it's going to sound. I'm just going to play measure one just for demonstration purposes. Okay. So if I start on one, I just get that first measure. Okay. 1, flat 3, 4, sharp 4, 5, flat 7, 8. I'll do one more the reason I give you guys that is because what you have right there, that knowledge, that's all you need to do improvisation. That's all you need to know. Okay, I know that sounds a little bit weird, and normally eighth grade at this point in the year we would actually do this in front of each other in class. So I guess you can take that either way. Some of you may be very very happy that I'm not making you do that in front of everybody. But what we're gonna do is we're gonna make up whatever we want to make up using that scale. Okay, now it can be something as simple as just going up and down the scale. It can go up halfway and maybe come back down. Okay, and you can mix up the rhythm a little bit too. You can jump around a little bit more, okay? Anything, okay? You can even go a little bit above or a little bit below the actual scale. Or a little below. You can really make up whatever you want to. I am just using the notes that were put in that scale and just making up whatever came to my head. I put no preparation into what I was about to play. Okay? Now, all over YouTube, there are these backing tracks. Okay? And basically, what it's doing is it's just playing the chord progression that we have for a 12-bar blues. Okay? And you can just improvise and solo up on top of it. Do whatever you want to it. Okay? Now, there's a whole bunch of them that you can find on YouTube for a concert, for a B flat blues, which is the one that we're playing right now. I'm going to be using a specific one just to kind of show you guys what I mean, but you don't have to use that one. You can look on YouTube and find other ones, and I'll put the link for the one I'm using below. But you can kind of use whatever you want to, okay? So first off, I'm going to play for you the video that I'm talking about, and I'll kind of show you can follow along with the chords, okay? So, then you go to a four, four, back to one, up to five, down to four, down to one, two. Okay, so you hear that one actually it did go to the five or just a second there, and it was kind of called the turnaround, and it brought us back to the very beginning. Okay? So now all I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna show you guys some examples of what you could play. Okay? I have no idea what I'm about to play. I'm just gonna kind of do whatever I want to. Okay? And the cool thing is with improvisation, it's gonna be right. Okay? So let's do it. Let me back up just a hair so I can get ready for the turnaround, and then I'll just play one time through and just give you an example. Okay, I'll play something simple and then maybe a little bit more complex. to mess up a little bit there, but it doesn't matter because it's all about just making it up and just doing whatever you want to, okay? You can do whatever you want to with this. This is just one backing track, like I was saying. There's dozens of other ones on YouTube. I encourage you to check some of them out and just kind of see which one you like playing with more. And just getting creative, okay? But what I want you guys to do is just have fun with that. Do whatever you want. Make up whatever you want. Get a little experimental. Try out something crazy, because if you mess up, who knows? It's improv. You're making it up. There's no right or wrong answer. As long as you stay within that scale, you're going to be right, okay? So what I want you guys to do is I want you to actually do this, for one, obviously. And I want you to actually do a recording, if you can. Record yourself doing it and playing with the music, and I want you to send it to me, because I want to hear kind of what you're doing and kind of see what you guys are coming up with. Okay, you can send it to my email, mgrimeswcpss.net. If you don't know how to find that, ask your parents. They know how to help, okay? Again, this is just one thing that I'm putting out for right now, guys. I'll be sending out some more stuff, hopefully, in the coming week, just to give you guys some stuff to work on. And then after spring break is when we start to kind of get into actual classes, and that's going to be kind of a little bit different, but we're going to kind of work with it, okay? All right, guys, have fun. Love you, miss you.